So let's start with Pix4D Cloud. This is one of the avatars of Pix4D, which you can use for processing your images and visualize the outputs. The website is cloud.pix4d.com. If you don't already have an account, do sign up. Fill out all the details. You get a 15-day trial with them, which is great. You can immediately get going. You can check out all the features of both Pix4D Cloud and desktop applications during this time, and then opt for a paid subscription later on. For the purpose of this tutorial, I have already created an account and I'm going to log in now. So here I am, logged into my account. Pix4D has four products. Pix4D Mapper, which is for surveying, mining, mapping, and forensics. Pix4D BIM for construction, earthworks, building information modeling and inspection, Pix4D Agriculture, and Pix4D Model for real estate. The difference between Pix4D Mapper and BIM is the interface. So let's look at examples to illustrate this. So click on Pix4D Mapper and go into the query example. This is the interface for Pix4D Mapper. This is used for one-time projects. This could be for a survey requirement when your customer has just bought the property and wants to do a topography survey, or for an urban town or city which needs mapping to be done to map out its properties and assets. Here is a download option. You can export the project to Pix4D Desktop and then work with it there. You can also download the individual outputs like the quality report, the .obj file, which is the source file of the 3D model, the point cloud, the orthomosaic, the DSM, and the processing log. You can use this interface for distance measurement and area measurement. You can toggle the elevations map and the satellite image as well. With the DSM, you can adjust the opacity from 0 to 1. 0 makes it completely invisible and 1 makes it fully visible. The same can be done for the orthomosaic. You can adjust the histogram of the DSM and show only a range or a certain range of the elevations. So that's the Pix4D Mapper. Now, let's look at Pix4D BIM. We'll open the example project that Pix4D has provided. Here, the interface that they provide maps out the same project along a timeline. So right now, it shows me the data for 27th March and how it looks like. This is a great way to map out the progress of the project across the timeline. So if you're doing a mapping of a construction project, for example, you can give your customer a periodic update on the progress of the construction using this interface. Now let's look at 4th October. Here's what the orthomosaic looks like on that date. You can zoom in. You can draw a polyline and get the measurement. A polygon for area measurement. If you click on the polygon, you can get the area details. The same way, if you click on the polyline, you will get the distance details. You can put a place mark and add notes. So here again, you can export all the outputs just like in Pix4D Mapper. Now here's the 3D model view, which was also available in Pix4D Mapper application. So let's load the 3D model. You can zoom in, zoom out, orbit, and so on. They also have Pix4D Ag for agricultural purposes, but we are not going to be covering that in this course. It needs special treatment and we'll bring that to you very soon. And then they have Pix4D Model. Now Pix4D Model just renders the 3D model for you. It doesn't generate any other outputs or analytics. So this is a 3D model example that they have. Now, let's upload a new dataset into Pix4D Mapper. So click on Upload New Project. Let's call it Test. So choose all the files, click Open, and it starts uploading. It shows you the progress here on this progress bar. Once the upload is done, click on Start Processing. The amount of time it takes really depends on the number of images you have uploaded. We've already uploaded and processed a project for this tutorial. So let's get into that. So this is an aerial survey project that I conducted for a site which is in pre-development stage. So let's try an area measurement here. I'm going to measure the area of this property. And there you go, it displays the area. And now, let's measure the length of this fence, for example. It displays the length of this fence. Now let's look at the DSM. You can reduce the opacity of the orthomosaic to look at the DSM completely. You can adjust the elevation histogram to look at specific elevation subsets of the area of interest. So here are the download options that they provide. You can download these and then do the needed post-processing, which we will talk about in part 2 of this course. And that's about it for Pix4D Cloud. Next, I'm going to take you through Pix4D Desktop.